വക്രതുണ്ട മഹാകായം സൂര്യകോടി സമപ്രഭ നിർവിഘ്നം കുരു മേ ദേവ സർവകാര്യേഷു സർവദാ സരസ്വതി നമസ്തുഭ്യം വരദേ കാമരൂപിണി വിദ്യാരംഭം കരിഷ്യാമി സിദ്ധിർഭവതു മേ സദാ ഗുരവേ സർവലോകാനാം വിഷജേ ഭവരോഗിനാം വിധയേ സർവവിദ്യാനാം ദക്ഷിണാമൂർത്തയേ നമഃ ഈശ്വരോ ഗുരുരാത്മേതി മൂർത്തിഭേദവിഭാഗിനേ വ്യോമവത്വ്യാപ്തദേഹായ ദക്ഷിണാമൂർത്തയേ നമഃ ശ്രുതിസ്മൃതിപുരാണാനാം ആലയം കരുണാലയം നമാമി ഭഗവത്പാദം ശങ്കരം ലോകശങ്കരം സദാശിവസമാരംഭാം ശങ്കരാചാര്യമധ്യമാം അസ്മദാചാര്യപര്യന്താം വന്ദേ ഗുരുപരംപരാം സാക്ഷാത്കൃതം ദയാനന്ദം പരമാർത്ഥസ്വരൂപിണം തത്വജ്ഞാനപ്രശാസ്താരം പ്രണതോസ്മി പരം പദം ഓം സഹനാവവതു സഹനോ ഭുനക്തു സഹവീര്യം കരവാവഹൈ തേജസ്വിനാവധീതമസ്തു മാ വിദ്വിഷാവഹൈ ഓം ശാന്തി ശാന്തി ശാന്തിഃ. ഓം പാർത്ഥായ പ്രതിബോധിതാം ഭഗവതാ നാരായണേന സ്വയം വ്യാസേന ഗ്രഥിതാം പുരാണമുനിനാ മധ്യേ മഹാഭാരതം അദ്വൈതാമൃതവർഷിണീം ഭഗവതീം അഷ്ടാദശാധ്യായിനീം അംബത്വാമനുസന്ദധാമി ഭഗവദ്ഗീതേ ഭവദ്വേഷിണീം നമോസ്തു തേ വ്യാസവിശാലബുദ്ധേ ഫുല്ലാരവിന്ദായ തപത്രനേത്ര യേന ത്വയാ ഭാരതതൈലപൂർണഃ പ്രജ്വാലിതോ ജ്ഞാനമയഃ പ്രദീപഃ പ്രപന്നപാരിജാതായ സ്തോത്രവേത്രൈകപാണയേ ജ്ഞാനമുദ്രായ കൃഷ്ണായ ഗീതാമൃതദുഹേ നമഃ സർവോപനിഷദോ ഗാവഃ ദുഗ്ധാ ഗോപാലനന്ദനഃ പാർത്ഥോ വത്സഃ സുധീർഭോക്താ ദുഗ്ധം ഗീതാമൃതം മഹത് വസുദേവസുതം ദേവം കംസചാണൂരമർദനം ദേവകീ പരമാനന്ദം കൃഷ്ണം വന്ദേ ജഗദ്ഗുരും ഭീഷ്മദ്രോണതടാജയദ്രഥജലാഗാന്ധാരനീലോത്പലാ शल्यग्राहवती कृपेण वहनी कर्णेन वेलाकुला अश्वत्थामविकर्णघोरमकरा दुर्योधनावर्तिनी सोत्तीर्णा खलु पाण्डवैरणनदी कैवर्तकेशवः पाराशर्यवचः सरोजममलं गीतार्थगन्धोत्कटं नानाख्यानकेसरं हरिकथा संबोधनाबोधितं लोके सज्जनषट्पदैरघरघः पेपीयमानं मुदा भूयाद्भारतपङ्कजं कलिमलप्रध्वंसिनश्रेयसे मूकं करोति वाचालं पङ्गुं लङ्घयते गिरिं यत्कृपात्तमहं वन्दे परमानन्दमाधवम् यं ब्रह्मा वरुणेन्द्ररुद्रमरुतः स्तुन्वन्ति दिव्यैस्तवैः वेदैः साङ्गपदक्रमोपनिषदैः गायन्ति यं सामगाः ध्यानावस्थिततद्गतेन मनसा पश्यन्ति यं योगिनः यस्यान्तं न विदुः सुरासुरगणाः देवाय तस्मै नमः नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरयेत्। I hope you all remember all the prayer verses and the Dhyana Shlokas of the Gita. We have been chanting this before every class. So, by this time, it would have got into your memory. As I told, I could not share the script today. So, hope that you also chanted with me.
Yes,
very good. And whatever Gita shlokas we learn every class, maybe 2, 3, 4, can keep chanting that so that you can commit that to memory. And before we start our class, before 10 minutes or even 5 minutes, whoever want to join the class for chanting, they can join before. We'll just chant from the beginning. How much ever we could chant, we can chant. So you also will be familiar with the script, with the shloka, you can comfortably read. So this chanting of Gita itself is it's punyam, because it is Bhagavataha Vachanam. So regular chanting of Gita, like any parayanam, Vishnu Sahasranamam, Lalita Sahasranam, any parayanam which we do, it is like a Gita parayanam. Daily parayanam is very helpful, beneficial for our spiritual growth. Gita gangodakam pitva punarjanmana vidyate. There is a statement. Gita ganga gangodakam. Drinking the water of Ganga and the Gita punarjanmana vidyate. There is no next janma. Mala nirmochanam pumsam jalam snana dine dine sakrit gita ambasi snanam samsara malanashanam. Gita ambasi snanam sakrit, once you take bath in the waters of Gita, that will destroy சம்சாரம், சம்சார மரணாசனம். டெய்லி யூ டேக் ஸ்நானம், ஜலஸ்நானம் தினே தினே. ஃபார் வாட்? மல நிர்மோச்சனம். இட் இஸ் ஃபார் தி ரிமூவல் ஆஃப் த இம்பியூரிட்டி, த டர்ட், ஃபிசிக்கல் டர்ட். தட் இஸ் ஃபிசிக்கல் கிளீனினஸ். பட் இஃப் யூ டேக் ஒன்ஸ் பாத் இன் தி கீதா, தட் வில் ரிமூவ் சம்சாரா ஃபார் எவர். இட்ஸ் அ ஸ்லோகா ஆன் கீதா. ஸோ யூ கேன் சாண்ட் கீதா ஆஸ் மெனி ஸ்லோகாஸ் பாசிபிள், and you can join the class before so that we can all chant. I once taught the whole chanting, Gita chanting, all the chapters, just few months before we completed that. After that only we started this Gita study. Okay, so now I will chant from the first shloka. I will chant, you all make sure that there is no noise around. Unmute your mic and repeat after me. Dhritarashtra uvacha.
Dhritarashtra uvacha.
Dharma kshetre kurukshetre.
Dharma kshetre kurukshetre.
சமவேதாயுயுத்ஸவஹ மாம காஃ பாண்டவாஶ்சைவ
மாம காஃ பாண்டவாஶ்சைவ
கிம குர்வத சஞ்சய
கிம குர்வத சஞ்சய
சஞ்சய உவாச
சஞ்சய உவாச
த்வா து பாண்டவானீகம்
த்ரிஷ்வா து பாண்டவானீகம்
வ்யூடம் துர்யோதனஸ்ததா
வ்யூடம் துர்யோதனஸ்ததா
ஆச்சாரியமுபசங்கம்ய
ஆச்சாரியமுபசங்கம்ய
ராஜா வசனமப்ரவீத
ராஜா வசனமப்ரவீத
பஷ்யைதாம் பாண்டுபுத்ராணாம்
பாண்டுபுத்ராணாம்
ஆச்சாரியமஹதீம் சமும்
ஆச்சாரியமஹதீம் சமும்
வ்யூடாம் த்ருபதபுத்ரேண
வ்யூடாம் த்ருபதபுத்ரேண
அவசிஷ்யேன தீமதா அத்ர சூரா மகேஷ்வாசாஹ
அத்ர சூரா மகேஷ்வாசாஹ
பீமார்ஜுன சமாயுதி
பீமார்ஜுன சமாயுதி
யுயுதானோ விராடஸ்ச த்ருபதஸ்ச மஹாரதஹ
த்ருபதஸ்ச மஹாரதஹ
த்ருஷ்டகேதுஶ்சேகிதானஹ
த்ருஷ்டகேதுஶ்சேகிதானஹ
காஷிராஜஶ்ச வீர்யவான்
காஷிராஜஶ்ச வீர்யவான்
புருஜித் குந்தி போஜஶ்ச
புருஜித் குந்தி போஜஶ்ச
சைப்யஶ்ச நர புங்கவஹ ருதாமன்யுஶ்ச விக்ராந்த
ருதாமன்யுஶ்ச விக்ராந்த
விக்ராந்தஹ
विक्रांतः
उत्तमोजाश्च वीर्यवान् सौभद्रो द्रौपदेयाश्च सर्व एव महारथाः ओके यू कैन म्यूट योर माइक नाउ This chanting is part of the class. What we chanted before the class is for our, just to for the people who wanted to learn the chanting. Okay. So we have seen the six shlokas of the first chapter, starting from Dhritarashtra Uvacha. The first shloka, Dhritarashtraha Uvacha, Dharma Kshetre, Kurukshetre, Ityadi. We saw that. That is the first shloka spoke, that is the words of Dhritarashtra. He wanted to know what was happening in the battlefield. Therefore, he called Sanjaya, his charioteer, and he asked, Hey Sanjaya, Dharma Kshetre, Dharma Pradhana Kshetre, and it has got a name, Kurukshetra, Kurukshetra Nama Pradeshe, Samavetaha, Sanyuktaha, Yodam Ichavaha, Yutsavaha, Mamakaha, Madiyaha, my people, Madiyaha, Pandavaha, Pandavaha cha, Panduputranam, sons of Pandu, Samavetaha assembled there, Kim Akurvata, what were they doing? Kim Kritavantaha, iti Dhritarashtraha Prachati. This is the question of Dhritarashtra, that is the first shloka. And Sanjaya replies, Sanjayaha Uvacha. Raja, that is Duryodhana, Tada Raja Duryodhanaha, Pandava anikam vyudam drishtva acharyam upasangamya vachanam abravid. The shloka is there, I am giving in the form of a sentence. Tada, tadanim, Raja Duryodhanaha. Raja is Duryodhana, Nirpaha Duryodhanaha. Pandava senyam vyugatvena sthapitam vyudam drishtva. Avalokya, having seen the Pandavas army assembled in an array, Acharyam, who is Acharya? Dronacharyam, Gurum Dronam Prati Gatva, Upasangamya, Upasrutya, Vachanam Abravid, Etat Vachanam Avadat. He spoke these words. So this is the Sanjaya says. And from the third shloka onwards, it is actually the statement of Duryodhana. But Duryodhana Uvacha is not there, but it is Duryodhana. So first shloka is a question of Dhritarashtra, and second shloka onwards, Sanjaya Uvacha. The second shloka says the Duryodhana approached the Dronacharya and spoke these words. What did these speak? From third shloka up to the sixth shloka, Duryodhana, he was giving a list of people on the side of his opponent, Pandavas. First, he gives the list of his opponents, Pandavas. And from the seventh shloka onwards, it gives the list of the people on his side. So, he says, the third shloka, Pashya. Etam Panduputranam Makatim Chamum He Acharya Dronacharya Etat Panduputranam Pandavanam Panduputranam Makatim Huge Drugatim Chamum Army Senam Pashya Ikshasva. See that తవ ధీమత శిష్యేన భవతః బుద్ధిమత శిష్యేన ద్రుపద పుత్రేన దృష్టం దృష్టద్యుమ్నేన దృష్టద్యుమ్నేన వ్యూఢం వ్యూఢాం వ్యూహరూపేణ స్థాపితం ఏతాం స్నేనాం సేనాం మహతీం సేనాం పశ్య ఈక్షస్వ. He says, you look at the army of these Pandavas, which were formed in an array by the son of Drupada. He is the commander-in-chief, Drushtadyumna. So look at that. He says, Atra, next shloka, Atra, Atra is Asmin, Asmin Kshetre, Asmin Yuddhasthane, Yuddhasthale, Asmin, Asmin, this place. అత్ర శూరాః మకేష్వాసాః భీమార్జున సమాయుధిః. హి గివ్స్ అ లిస్ట్ ఆఫ్ పీపుల్ హు ఆర్ ఇన్ దిస్ యుద్ధక్షేత్ర. అస్మిన్ యుధి యుద్ధే యుయుధానః విరాటః ద్రుపదః దృష్టకేతుః చేకితానః కాశీరాజః పురుజిత్ కుంతిభోజః శైభ్యః యుధామన్యః ఉత్తమౌజాః సౌభద్రః. Subhadra is the son of Subhadra, that is Abhimanyu. Draupadeyaha, Draupadeyaha is sons of Draupadi. Draupadi, she had sons with the five Pandavas. So they are all Draupadeyaha, Upapandavaha. And who are all they? Bhima, Arjuna, Samaha. They are everybody, all the people. They are like equivalent to Bhima and Arjuna. భీమార్జున సమానాః వీరాః సర్వే మహా ఇష్వాసః మహా చాపవంతః. దే ఆర్ వెరీ గుడ్ ఇన్ ఆర్చరీ అండ్ దే ఆర్ ఆల్ మహారథాస్ అతిరథ. డిఫరెంట్ కేటగిరీస్ ఆర్ దర్. హి గివ్స్ ది లిస్ట్ ఆఫ్ పీపుల్. దే ఆర్ ఆల్ పీపుల్ హు ఆర్ ది అసెంబ్ల్డ్ దేర్ ఆన్ ది అపోనెంట్ సైడ్. సో here Drishtaketuhu, some interesting information about these people. Every name has got a vyutpatti, and there is a commentary by Shankarananda. Who is Shankarananda? Shankarananda, I think he was the guru of Vidyaranya Muni. Vidyaranya was the pontiff of Sringeri Mata. His famous acharya is Guru Shankarananda. So yeah, I think he wrote a Vyakhyanam on Gita, Shankaranandiyam. So in that commentary, his book, he was given the Vyutpatti, the etymology of some of the names like Drishtaketuhu. Some names he has given. That is very interesting to know. Drishtaketuhu. Drishtaketuhu means Drishtaha Bhayankaraha. Parabhayankaraha Ketuhu. Asya iti Drishtaketu. Drishtaha means Parabhayankaraha. Very Bhayankaraha. That causes fear. Drishta. Ketuhu means body. The one whose body is, it causes fear in the opponent. Is a Drishtaketuhu. చేకితానః. చికితానస్య అపత్యం పుమాన్ చేకితానః. చికితాన ఇస్ వన్ ఆఫ్ ది యాదవ చీఫ్టెన్. సో హిస్ సన్ ఇస్ చేకితానః. పురుజిత్. యుద్ధే పురూన్ బహూన్ జయతి ఇది పురుజిత్. ఇన్ ది యుద్ధ ఈ కాంకోర్స్ పురుస్. దట్ ద వన్ హూ కాంకోర్స్ పురుస్ ఇస్ కాల్డ్ పురుజిత్. కుంతిభోజః. కుంతిభోజః కుంతిపిత. శైభ్యః. శిభేహే గోత్రాపత్యం శైభ్యః. ద వన్ హూ హాస్ కమ్ ఇన్ ది లీనేజ్ ఆఫ్ శిభే, దర్ఫోర్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ శైభ్యః. దేర్ ఆల్ నరపుంగవః. శైభ్యశ్చ నరపుంగ. శైభ్య ఇస్ నరపుంగవ. ఇస్ అన్ అడ్జెక్టివ్ టు శైభ్య. నరపుంగవః మీన్స్ the most exalted among among the human beings, he is the most exalted. Punga, Nara Pungavaha Punga literally means bull. It's a bull. But it's not the we don't translate it as a bull among bull means is most exalted, powerful. That is the idea. So Naranam Nareshu Pungavaha Iti. Narapungavaha Shaibhyaha Iti. Yudhamanyuhu. Yudhamanyuhu Chavikrantaha. Yudha. Yude manyuhu. Manyu means anger. Kopa Vegaha. Yudhe. Yudhamanyuhu. Yudha means yudhe. Yudhayam. Yudhe. Yudhe manyuhu. Kopa Vegaha. Yasyasaha. Yudhamanyuhu. The one who has the anger. He displays his anger. Anger means that comes when you face the opponent, the bravery. That is the Yudhamanyuhu. Yudhamanyuhu is the Satyaki. Uttamojaha. Uttama Mojaha Balam Yasya. Uttamojaha is a Panchala. King of Panchala. Viryavan Saubhadraha. That is, we know, Subhadrayaha Putraha Saubhadraha. And they are all Maharatas. Sarva Eva Maharataha. Here he says all these people are Maharatas. Who is a Maharata? Eko Dasha Sagasrani Yodaye Vyastu Dhanvinam Shastra Shastra Pravinascha Maharataha Iti Smrtaha. So the person who can fight with 10,000 Dasha Sagasrani 10,000 bowmen, and who is has got expertise in handling the military weapons, is called Maharata. So all these people are Maharataha. So Duryodhana, he says, he gives a list of people on the side of the Pandavas, whose army is well arranged, well arrayed by the Drupada Putra Drishtadyumna. Now he is going to give a list of people on his side. That is the 7th shloka. Starting from 7th shloka. I will chant. You can repeat. Asmakam tu visishtaye.
Asmakam tu visishtaye.
Nibodha Dvijotama Nayaka Mama Sainyasya Sanyartham Tan Bravimite.
Okay, you can mute your mic now. Asmakam, on our side, Asmakam. Asmakam tu Visishtaha. Visishtaha, excellent. Significant people, Asmakam, on our side. Who are they? Asmakam, Visishtaha. Ye Visishtaha. These are Visishtaha. These are important, very important people on our side. Tan Nibodha. He Dvijotama. Tan Nibodha. Dvijotama addressing Dronacharya. He is a Dvija. He Dvijotama. Tan Nibodha. Please. You know, I tell you know. Mama Sainyasya Nayakaha. Te. Mama Sainyasya Nayakaha. My armies, they are my army's heroes. Heroes of my army. Sanyartam Tan Bravimite. I give the names of those people in an orderly way. I tell you for your knowledge. So this is the statement of Duryodhana. We look into it further. So now Duryodhana, he gives a list, calling, addressing the Acharya, Dronacharya, as Dvijottama. Hey, Dvijottama. Dvijanam Uttama, Dvijottama. Hey, Dronacharya. Who is a Dvija? What is Dvija? Dvija means the one who is born two times, twice born. Twice born is called a Dvija. A Brahmana is a Dvija. A Kshatriya is also a Dvija. Vaishya is also a Dvija. Dvija is the one who has been initiated into the important samskara, that is Gayatri Upadesha. That Upanayana ceremony, by investing a boy when he attains the age of 8 or 10, that time only Upanayanam should be done. So once that Upanayanam, you do that Upanayanam ceremony, that is you give the Gayatri Upadesha to the son and send him to the Gurukula Vasa, Gurukulam. So that is this ceremony, and by that samskara, a person is born again. A person is born again. Therefore, twice born. And what is the first birth? First birth is from the womb of the mother. That is the first jananam, first birth. The second birth is when initiated into the Gayatri Mantra by the father, he is born again. That is a samskara. So he gets the permission of the tradition of the people, of the family and the gurus for learning Vedas. To learn Vedas, one must be initiated into the Gayatri Mantra. So that is an important samskara. And the readiness for that is indicated by this sacred thread. So the one who is as a sacred thread means he is initiated into the Gayatri Mantra. So that is a ceremony. By that, a person becomes a Dvija. So not only Brahmanas are invested with this sacred thread. Brahmana, Kshatriya and Vaishya. Except Shudra. Who is Shudra? Those things, it all came later. Shudras, one who refrained from studying Vedas, they are called Shudra, literally speaking. Veda being the Apurusheya Pramanam given by Bhagavan, everybody has got the right to study Vedas. Those who did not show interest, they are Shudra. Even though, even a Brahmana who doesn't study Veda is a Shudra only. He may be a Jati Brahmana, but he has not been given this sacred thread. He has not been initiated with the Gayatri Mantra. Then he is not a Brahmana at all. By just having the Jati Brahmana is of no use. So, therefore, the really speaking, the caste system is not there. It all came based on Jati, the birth later. By Jati, we can say a person is a Brahmana, Kshatriya, that is. By Guna, you can say. By Karma, you can say. By Karma, a person can become a Brahmana also. By Karma, a person can become a Kshatriya also. Here, this Dronacharya, by birth, he was a Brahmana, Jati Brahmana. By profession, by Karma, he is a Kshatriya Brahmana. He became a Kshatriya. From Brahmana, he became a Kshatriya because of his profession. He didn't teach Shastram. He didn't teach Vedas and all. He didn't teach Samhita, all those portions, Upanishad. He didn't teach. He taught archery. He taught the military skills. So therefore, it's because of his profession, he became a Kshatriya. So Brahmana Kshatriya. There are many people like that. Parashurama also is there. The Brahmana, but he killed many Kshatriyas. He wanted to avenge. Therefore, he took a oath and destroyed all the Kshatriyas. So, Brahmana Kshatriya. So, everybody The first, when they take the first birth, every human being is a Shudra only. Janmana jayate Shudraha. By birth, everybody is a Shudra. Because that is, you have come into the world, but not yet given any samskaras. Samskarat dvija uchyate. When you are given the samskara, samskara is the list of rituals which are given to a child from the beginning until he grows, till up to the smashana ground, till the whole lifespan, he has to undergo a list of samskaras. 16 shodasha samskaras are the important samskaras. And the first is starting from annaprashanam and namakaranam, and this is upanayanam. So samskarat dvija uchyate. So janmana jayate shudraha samskarat dvija uchyate. Vedapatena bhavet vipraha brahma janati brahmanaha. It clearly says the one who knows Brahman is a brahmana. Vedapatena bhavet vipraha. By studying Vedas, you become a vipra. You become a knowledgeable person. You become a wise person. And only when you know Brahman, a person becomes a brahmana. So brahmana doesn't mean only a jati brahmana. You can say jati brahmana is also a brahmana, but really speaking, the one who knows Brahman, that Brahman is not separate from me, aham brahma smi, who understands the mahavakyam, who gets the upadesham from the guru, understands the mahavakyam, he is a brahmana. Therefore here Duryodhana, he addresses Dronacharya, because he was a Brahmana. Hey Dvijottama, eight wise born, hey Dronacharya. Asmakam Kauravanam. That is, we Kauravas, on our side, Visishtaha. The Upasarga says they are all not ordinary people, Asadharana people. Asadharanaha, Visishtaha. Ye, Yodharaha. They are all Yodharaha. They are all warriors. Asmakam, ye, Visishtaha, Tan. Those people, Nibodha, you know. Nibodha, Janihi. Bodhasva, you know. Oh, twice born, the people on our side, they are all great people, you know them. Not that Dronacharya did not know, he knows, but still Duryodhana says, they are all what? Mama sainyasya, mama senayaha nayakaha. They are all the heroes, nayakaha. Tan, I give tubhyam to you. Sanyartam is samyak jnanartam, for the clear knowledge of you. For the clear knowledge of you, agam bravimi, agam nevedayami, agam vadami. So I give the list of those people to you. This is the statement of Duryodhana. Here we will look into some important points. Since Duryodhana gave the list of people on the Pandavas first, probably you would have thought, Duryodhana would have thought, that hearing the powerful person on the side of Pandava, then Dronacharya probably would have thought, so let us not fight, let us not battle with this, it is not proper to fight with this powerful people, so let us withdraw from this battle. Dronacharya could have thought like this, thinks Duryodhana. Duryodhana thinks, that Dronacharya would have thought like this when I mentioned, when I gave the list of people on the Pandava side. Therefore, he says, Asmakam. Not only on the side of Pandavas, even on our side, there are people are there. There are great people are people are there. Therefore, the tu shabda, asmakam tu, the tu, it indicates, the tu shabda, it indicates that the fear which is on, which is the fear which is caused because of the mention of the names of the warriors on the Pandava side, to remove that, tu shabda is used. The tu shabda is to remove the fear caused by the names, the powerful persons on the side of Pandavas. So don't think there are only powerful people on that side. Asmakam tu, tu, that is the tu shabda. So agam nibod, tan nibodha, tan nischayena madvachanat avadaraya. So I tell you, and you clearly know those people. Not that Dronacharya did not know, but still, for the sake of giving it in an order and for the clear information, so he gives a list of those people. So this is what the Duryodhana says. Now we can move to the next shloka. Shloka number 8 starts giving the names of the people. Bhavan Bhishmascha Karnascha.
Bhavan
Bhishmascha Karnascha.
Kripascha Samitinjayaha.
Kripasya samitinjayah
Ashvatthama vikarnasya
Ashvatthama vikarnasya
Saumadattisthathaivacha
Saumadattisthathaivacha
Saumadattisthathaivacha Saumadattihi. So you can mute your mic now. He gives a list of the people, starting from Bhavan. Bhavan is you. First he mentions Bhavan. You are there, Bhavan. Bhavan api. Bhavan. First is Bhavan. You are there. So, Tan Nibodha, what he said in the previous shloka, that he gives. Tan eva visishtan svasena nayakan pariganayati. He pariganaya, Duryodhana pariganayati. Pariganayati means gives a list starting from Bhavan ityadi. You are there. Bhishmaha is there. Bhishmaha cha, Bhishmascha. Karna is there. Karna is the right person for the right answer for Arjuna. So Karna is there. Kripaha is there. Who is Kripa? Kripa, he was the brother of Dronacharya's wife Kripi. He also taught archery to the Kauravas and the Pandavas. And Kaurava, this Kripacharya is one of the Chiranjeevi. Kripa and Ashwatthama also. Chiranjeevi, they live forever, they say. So these two people, Kripaha is there. And who is Kripaha? There is an adjective to it. Samitinjayaha. Veeranamapi yuddhakriyam jayati iti samitinjayaha. The one who is victorious, who conquers, jayati yuddhakriyam. In the yuddhakriyam, with regard to the battlefield, the one who always wins, that is a samitinjayaha. It's an adjective to Kripaha. Ashwatthama, the son of Dronacharya and the friend of Duryodhana. And Vikarna. Vikarna is one of the brothers of Duryodhana. Vikarna. And Somadattihi. Somadattihi is another person who is also on the side of the Pandava. Somadatti is the son of Somadatta. Somadattihi. Somadattasya apatyam puman Somadattihi. Like Dasharatasya apatyam puman Dasharatihi. Dasharati is the son of Dasharata. Dasharatihi. And Janakasya apatyam Janakasya putri Janaki. So Dasharatihi, Janaki. Here similarly Somadatti. Somadatti, son of Somadatta is Somadattihi. So then Sanskritam, that Adi Vriddhi will happen. The first letter will have a Vriddhi letter. So that indicates son. Like Vasudevasya apatyam puman Vasudevaha. Vasudeva, Vasudeva, difference is there. They are not same. Vasudeva, father. Vasudeva, son. Krishna. So similarly, here, the son of Somadatta. So the is also on this side. Somadattihi tatayivacha. Okay, then the next shloka. Tatayeva cha is going to continue.
Anye cha bhagavashuraha.
Madharthe
tyakta jivitaha.
Nana
shastra prakaranaha.
Sarve
yudha
visharadaha.
Sarve
yudha visharadaha.
Okay.
Anye.
Anye means others. Others. Anye shuraha. Other shuraha. Other warriors, they are also present. Bhagavaha, they are many in number. They are many in number.
Nana shastra prakaranaha shuraha sarve yuddha visharadaha anyecha bhagavaha madarte tyakta jivitaha santi.
The meaning is, there are many other warriors who are all this experts. They have the expertise in handling the military weapons, warfare, military warfare. And they are ready to give up their lives for the sake of me. And they are present on my side. This is the simple meaning.
Anye. Anye means itare. Other. Shuraha. Shuraha vikraminaha. Warriors. How many are the number? Anye, when you say Bhagavaha, many are there, not one, many. Aneke. Aneke shuraha vikraminaha santi. Who are they? Madarte tyakta jivitaha. Madarte, for the sake of me. Mamakrute. Madarte means mamakrute. Tyakta jivitaha. Jivitam. That life is ready for giving for Duryodhana. Tyakta jivita, who are given up actually. They have given up their life for me. But they are alive. But why did Duryodhana says they have given up? We will see. Tyakta jiv, who have given up their life. It means probably Duryodhana knows they will not go back alive after the war. So tyakta jivitaha, they have given up their life. For what? For whom? Madarte, Mamakrte, for the sake of me. And who are all day? Nana Shastra Pragaranaha. They are capable of handling different, nana, various, Shastram. Shastram Astram. Astram means, as from the Dhatu Asdhatu, that which can be thrown, that is called Astram. Shastram is that which we can fight. So, Astra Shastra. So, they are Bhagu Shastraha, Nana Vida Shastraha. They are all endowed with various weapons. Sarve Yuddha Visharadaha. They have the expertise, Nipunaha. Yuddha Shastra Nipunaha. Not only Shastra, they know practical also. Not only theory, they are the experience in on the practical side also. So they are all on my side. Bhagavaga Shuraha. Shuraha Shaurya Shalinaha. Shauryam Viryam. They are all brave people. So Nana Vidani Shastrani. Nana Shastra Praganaha. Nana Vida Shastrani. Shula Chakra Gada Khadga Parighadini. Shula. Shula means trident. Chakra. Chakra is that wheel, disc, gada, gadai, spear, kadga, sword, parigada, that iron mace. So they are all endowed with all these various weapons. So nana vidani shastrani prakarana sadhanani yeshamte nana shastra prakaranaha. They are all endowed, they're all with these various weapons. Nana Shastra Praganaha. So this is an adjective to the people on the side of the Pandavas. Nana Shastra Praganaha is an adjective. Madarte Tekta Jivitaha, that is also. Madarte Tekta Jivitaha, Nana Shastra Praganaha, Yuddha Visharadaha, Sarve. All these are adjective to the people on the side of the Pandavas. And the Duryodhana, it says, on the side of Duryodhana. Te sarve madarte mad vijaya siddhyai tyakta jivitaha. For the victory of me, they have given up their life. Prana tyagena api jayam sampadayishyamaha. By giving their life also, they are ready to give victory for me. And those people are there on my side. And here, Tyakta Jivitaha, who have given up the life also, he says, why? Probably Duryodhana, he knows. Though the Pandavas are less than number of the Akshoyini, but still, since Krishna is on their side and though Dronacharya Bhishma on their side, he has a doubt that Drona will be partial to Pandavas, and Bhishma, nobody can conquer him, nobody can kill him, but still will he not lift his weapon in the battle, all these samshayas. So Duryodhana's main strength was only Karna. He is the best answer for Karna, for Arjuna. Karna is the best answer for Arjuna. But that is the main person Duryodhana has. But he has samshaya about the other people. He has got doubts about the other people. So, and seeing the valor and the power of Arjuna and Bhima and all, he has got some fear. So, probably would have concluded that he will not win the war. Though they are... Duryodhana's are huge in number. Duryodhana army is a huge one. But still, he had a little doubt. And that came out in the form of a shabda, a word itself. So a word which comes out from the mouth of Duryodhana itself indicates what is going to happen. So Duryodhana probably would have concluded. Some indication he would have got. That's why he said, Tyakta Jivitaha. who have given up their life. Why should you say tyakta jivitaha? So, they've given up their life in the battlefield. It means they're all dead. They are gone away. Why should, if he is going to be victorious in the battle, why should you say tyakta jivitaha? So, therefore, the words which came out from the mouth of Duryodhana itself indicates that they will be defeated by the Pandavas. So that idea was there. That somehow that conclusion, a slight, conclusion, it had entered into the mind of Duryodhana, and that came out in the form of this word, tyakta jivitaha. Every word is important. Every word has got something to convey. So, tyakta jivitaha sarve. And now, Duryodhana, he continues. He is going to tell who is protecting the army on the Pandava side as well as on the Kaurava side. Aparyaptam tadasmakam.
Aparyaptam tadasmakam.
Balam bhishma bhirakshitam.
Balam bhishma bhirakshitam.
Paryaptam tvidametesham.
Paryaptam tvidametesham.
Balam bhima bhirakshitam.
Balam bhima bhirakshitam.
Okay. Aparyaptam. Aparyaptam, first I will give one meaning and then explain. Paryaptam, paryaptam means limited. That is one meaning, paryaptam. Aparyaptam means not limited, unlimited. Tat asmakam balam aparyaptam. Asmakam balam. Asmakam, that is on ours, our balam, our strength is asmakam means kauravanam. Kauravanam balam, sainya balam, the strength of the army, aparyaptam. Aparyaptam, it is not limited, it is unlimited. We have unlimited power. This is taking the meaning of unlimited. Paryaptam, taking the meaning of limited, unlimited. Aparyaptam is unlimited. Bhishma abhirakshitam. Bhishmena abhirakshitam. Abhirakshitam, protected by Bhishma. Bhishmena abhirakshitam, samrakshitam. Asmakam sainyam. Tasya balam aparyaptam. The army, the power of our army, it is unlimited. Why? Because it is protected by Bhishma, Bhishmacharya. Why Bhishma? Bhishma is such a powerful person, nobody can go near him. Nobody can handle Bhishma. Even Arjuna also cannot handle Bhishma. When Arjuna, he was fighting with Bhishma, though Krishna wanted Arjuna to aim at Bhishma and finish him. When he, Chikandi in the chariot, Chikandi is neither a woman nor a man, so Chikandi. And Bhishma will fight only with men, not with any other people. So when Shikhandi was placed in the chariot of Arjuna, Bhishma dropped his weapon. At that time, Krishna wanted Arjuna to release and kill him. But Arjuna was hesitating. Then Krishna was ready. And seeing that Bhishma was destroying the Pandavas army, he himself was ready. He took up his weapon, chakra, and wanted to kill Bhishma. Seeing that itself, Bhishma understood. Then Krishna himself got ready to kill me, then that is the end for me. My life is ending. So he decided to end his life. Therefore, he dropped his weapon and he was ready to accept the arrows of Arjuna. So unless he drops his weapon, unless he allows himself to be killed by others, nobody can touch him, kill him. Such a powerful person, Bhishma. And therefore, that Bhishma is the protector of our army, which is unlimited. Duryodhana says, Asmakam balam, Bhishmena abhirakshitam asmakam senyasa balam aparyaptam, unlimited. Whereas, paryaptam tu idam etesham tu, whereas, again here also tu, whereas etesham, etesham, etesham means us pandavana, whereas etesham, these people, pandavas bhalam, sainya bhalam, the strength of their army, paryaptam, limited. Whereas the strength of the pandavas army, it is limited. And it is protected by whom? Bhima abhirakshitam. Bhimena samrakshitam. It is protected by Bhima. Protected by Bhima, the strength of the Pandavas army is limited. Whereas our strength is unlimited. This is one meaning. This meaning is the right meaning. Taking into consideration the number of Akshogini, taking into consideration the number of Akshoginis, this is the right meaning. What is Akshogini? An Akshogini is an army which has got 21,870 chariots, 21,870 elephant riders, 65,610 horse riders and 1,09,350 foot soldiers, infantries. So you can imagine one Akshogini, it has so many people. And the Duryodhana side, Duryodhana had 18 Akshogini, whereas Pandava, they had only 11. So whose army is limited? Whose army is better in terms of number? Of course, Duryodhana's side. Therefore, he says it is unlimited. Our army is unlimited. The power of our army is unlimited. Whereas Pandava's side, they have only 11 Akshoginis. Therefore, their strength, though protected by Bhima, it is limited. Paryaptam. This is one meaning. And there is another meaning given to this shloka, taking the meaning of the word aparyaptam, which is not acceptable, but it is, that meaning also is given. I tell you that meaning also. Aparyaptam means, it can also mean not sufficient. Aparyaptam can also mean not sufficient. Asamartam ityartaha, not capable. Asamartam, not sufficient, insufficient, aparyaptam. So our army, which is protected by Bhishma, it is not sufficient. That meaning also possible. Whereas the army protected by Bhima, it is paryaptam, sufficient. Though they are less in number, they have all the great people, excellent warriors. So they are paryaptam, they are sufficient. That meaning also some people give. But taking into account the number of Akshogini, this meaning doesn't fit. Therefore, we don't take the meaning of aparyaptam as insufficient. We will take the meaning as unlimited. So that meaning seems to fit very well here. So this different meanings also I'm giving so that you can see how it is interpreted. Paryaptam, even when you go to the dining hall here, the ashram, when people gave food, when the food falls in your plate, they will ask, if it is paryaptam, you have to say paryaptam, enough. Paryaptam is enough, sufficient. That meaning is, general meaning is there, paryaptam. So, that paryaptam, people can think it is not sufficient. It is sufficient. Paryaptam sufficient, aparyaptam insufficient. So, that meaning, not to, better not to take here. Okay. So, this is these are the words of Duryodhana. Then, the next shloka starts with ayaneshu cha sarveshu, that we will see it in the next class. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Hari Om.
Danyavadaji.
If any doubt, you can ask. What is
Danyavadaji?
There won't be any doubts in these classes because we have not yet got into the teaching. But if you have doubts in Sanskritam, you can ask. Those who are attending the advanced class, if they have any doubt in Sanskritam, after the class you can ask. I'll stop recording now.